I have made a lot of travel mistakes while abroad, so let's go through those and unpack them together. So I'm going to give you a little bit of backstory. So I actually studied abroad twice. I studied abroad in England and I also studied abroad in Mexico. And the one in actually London was longer and it was also in an apartment stay. And also my trip to Mexico was like a short interim trip that was just over a month. And I was also staying with a host family. So, and also when I was abroad in England specifically, I had more time to travel and also it was very affordable to travel there. So I traveled to 9 countries while I was there. So I can give you guys some amazing travel tips and mistakes that I made. So firstly, the biggest mistake that I made was actually when I traveled to London. This was a semester long trip. And I was actually there during the rainy season. So that was between January to May. And I was very excited to be there, but I did not pack properly for the trip. So I'm actually from Wisconsin in the United States. And Wisconsin is known for being very cold. I don't know if you guys know that, but we are basically like right next to Canada. So I'm used to cold weather and snow. And I knew that I was gonna be there during the rainy season, but it was warmer temperatures and I wasn't expecting to need a lot of layers or big puffy jackets. And I was actually pleasantly surprised when I got there. When I actually dealt with the cold and wet rain, what happened was I actually had an issue. I also didn't bring an umbrella too in this situation, but I bought one when I was there in Primark. It is the UK version of a Target and I love it so much. So thank you for Primark for keeping me safe. But anyway, so when I didn't bring my umbrella that day, I was pleasantly shocked by how much it was raining there. And even though it was like 57 degrees, but it was a different kind of cold. Like in Wisconsin, it's more of a dry cold. And in England, it's a wet cold. So it's different. So even though it was warmer there, I felt colder, if that made sense. So I actually needed a jacket, like a puffer jacket, like a winter jacket. But I didn't bring any. So what I had to do was I also went to Primark again. Thank you, Primark, for saving my life for the millionth time. Actually, probably more than a million times when I was there because they have great prices too. But I was gonna say too that when I went there, I ended up buying several jackets and thank God I did because I was dying and I did not think that through enough. And honestly, I felt bad because that was just me being young and dumb because I was like, oh yeah, like I'll be fine. I was not fine. Who else would have made that mistake though? Maybe if you lived in the South, you wouldn't have because you guys are like that. But like someone like me who literally grew up next to Canada, like there's no, I've never thought I would need a coat for 55 degree weather and raining. But yeah, so just letting you guys know, if you ever, always bring extra layers, even if it's like one, you never know. And the problem was too, so I did not want to pay for like an overweight bag or also bring more than one bag because one, that would be awful, you know, to do that myself, but also the cost, right? And so I had to condense everything into one bag, 50 pounds. And I also stuffed up my carry-on bag. That was probably even heavier than my checked bag. Actually, that's a secret. I don't know if you guys know that. Most airlines do not weigh your carry-on. Maybe they do now, but like you can get away with like having heavy laptop. Because I also had a really heavy laptop at the time. It was like this big Dell and I had to bring it with me and I brought my iPad in there. I put heavy stuff in there so that I could bring more, if that made sense. And also like important things, like my things that I didn't want to lose, like my laptop, my iPad. I don't know what else was in there, but it was heavy. It honestly felt like 50 pounds. Maybe it felt heavier though because I was carrying it the whole time in the airport, but that's also a good tip too. But another thing too is I had to make sure that, if I had to tell anyone anything, what I learned from that situation is make sure that you don't forget anything. And also make sure you think about everything when it comes to clothing because you'll be pleasantly shocked when it comes to climate and everything like that and how you're feeling personally. So even though I was from little Wisconsin, I still needed a jacket. So I had to go buy one. And it was fine though. Thank God I could buy one. But it was just kind of like, oh yeah, I'll be fine. No. And yeah, I definitely also needed an umbrella too. But the good thing is, Primark is very affordable. And I was able to buy a few coats. And they're cute, but they were Target worthy. So I was very happy to have had that. But I wish I would have just brought my own. More than one, if that made sense. Because I only brought one coat. It wasn't like a big, heavy coat, if that made sense. So I needed something with more layers to it, more heat. And I didn't think I would need that. So I had some layers, but there wasn't enough, if that made sense. So yeah, that was honestly a big fail on my part. Also, another mistake that I made was also in England. So I think the semester trip actually really screwed me up because I've never done anything like that before. So it was an experience. That's a long time to be away. It's a whole different ballpark. So also what happened was when I was there, I did not look up transportation like I should have. And I'm telling you guys because you can learn from my lesson. So when I was planning on my trip, I had actually contacted someone in the group who was flying there in the same area as me and was in my trip. So we actually booked flights for the same airline and also the same airport. So we planned on carpooling to our student housing because we lived in a student housing apartment, if it made sense. So it was in South Kensington in London and it was a very pretty area. But so we planned on doing a taxi, but I actually wish we would have researched more instead of just like doing that because anyway, we are from smaller towns and smaller states, if that makes sense. So we were like, oh yeah, we can just like take a taxi there our first day because I think we were, I'm not actually sure if this is true or not, but I'm almost positive we were either like a red eye flight or either like we got there pretty late where it was like we weren't sure if we wanted to figure out the subway system and walking to the apartment, if that made sense. So this is a while ago. This was 2016 actually, so.
It was also the fact that we didn't want to figure out the subway the first night we got there in London. So we wanted to take a taxi thinking that it wouldn't be too terribly expensive if we split it. And we were actually very humbled. So it was $75 for an in-city cab and I never took a cab ever again. And I don't think you guys would either.
Also another lesson I learned, I'm not sure if it was in England, if not, it was probably in the UK or Europe, but it was definitely not Mexico where this happened because I can tell you why. Because so Mexico is very affordable, so this is not even valid there, if that made sense. So anyway, what happened was I made a very terrible mistake when I was in this country and my friends and I were going to eat lunch. So what happened was I ended up ordering a water, okay, a bottled water, okay, and you want to know what they brought up? A big, fancy, giant water bottle. Like, fancy. Big for the entire table. Like, it almost looked like a big, fancy wine bottle. Okay? Guess what, though? Guess how much it was. Just take a guess. For a water bottle that I ordered. $22! Are you kidding me? I literally never wanted to order a water ever again. Like, what on earth? So I had to tell you guys that be careful when you're ordering drinks. And if you're ordering, you could always ask you like, oh, how much is this? Like, that's totally valid. But the thing is, the biggest mistake I made was I did not know the cost of it. And I did not know I was ordering that, if that made sense. So it wasn't like I was ordering it in a country that I wasn't, it was, okay, but I have to say this too. It was not in a country where I did not know the language. So it was definitely somewhere that spoke English. So it could have been England or one of the UK countries, if it makes sense. Like it wasn't anywhere that didn't speak English. So it wasn't like France or anything like that. But yeah, so it was a horrifying experience, but I learned a valid lesson to ask prices. But oh my God, I was so horrified, you guys, that that was, and as a college kid, like, what? So another mistake that we made was in England, and this is specifically one of my roommates, actually, so I'm going to tell you her story so you can learn from it, but we all mutually learn from the story, if that made sense. So this is another transportation issue, actually. So the first time that we tried using Uber was one of my roommates, and she had a horrible, horrible situation come up. So I'm going to tell you guys so you can be aware. So make sure you are researching when it comes to transportation, what's safe, what's not safe. So she ordered an Uber, and it was not safe, and she had to call the police and file a police report. She felt unsafe. She had to leave the vehicle. So it was a very terrible exchange. She felt like she couldn't get out, and the driver was like pulling away, not letting her out. So I don't know if he was like foreign or just up to no good, but apparently Uber in other countries sometimes isn't, well, sometimes Uber in other countries isn't even a thing. So check that out. And two, sometimes it's not even checked, like background checked, if that makes sense. So it's not as valid in other countries. So just keep that in mind. So we learned the hard way when it came to that. So another issue that happened, this one's actually pretty scary. This happened to one of the people who was actually on my trip in Mexico. And by the way, Mexico is a very fun place and I loved it so much. I actually loved it a lot more than I thought I was going to. My family was amazing. But on this trip, our professor told us to make sure that we were careful not to drink any water that wasn't filtered, and also to not drink any drinks with ice in them because it could get us very sick. So if you're traveling to another country, that is a good tip to not get sick, especially if the water quality is different. You know what I mean? And even if you're traveling in the United States, just be careful. Even if you're drinking different tap water, you can even mess up your system, if that makes sense. So just keep that in mind. When you're traveling, you should be extra careful. So it can cause you to get sick. And someone in our program did get sick from this. So just keep that in mind because I did not have any issues from this too. But yeah, that is the easiest way to get sick in very uncomfortable situations. And also too, it's very traumatic when you're in a different country, especially for the first time. And maybe even away from your family or friends too. But yeah, and also in a different medical system too. Thank goodness we just had to go to the pharmacy and pick her up something, but it was absolutely terrifying. But yeah, so just make sure that you're doing your research, make sure you're not doing that. And also, yeah, filtered water is the option. So if there's nothing filtered when it comes to water and ice, don't even ask for the ice because normally they wouldn't even know that answer. You know what I mean? Like, they're just wait staff. Like, why would they know that? Maybe if they're at a fancy restaurant, but most places do not use, isn't that weird to think about now? Like, why do we ask for ice and water if they don't filter it? You know what I mean? Like, isn't that kind of gross now that you think about it? Like, now I think about it, I'm like, I don't really like that idea now. But anyway, thought. So another thing that happened is, that's a valid lesson from that situation, is to definitely make sure that you guys are being careful when it comes to what you're drinking, what you're, and also what you're eating too. So, just keep that in mind too, and make sure you're doing your research. But also too, another thing that I did is make sure that you're either taking a probiotic or eating it. So in yogurt is another good way. Yeah, so if you guys liked this video, let me know. I can give you some more travel content because I got a bunch of it. So I hope you guys enjoy. Bye.